Hello everyone, welcome to my channel again. Let us see another one more role play regarding hospital diabetic clinic. So here I am presenting you one diabetic patient who came to the clinic to seek medical attention for his infected foot. So let us
see what happened. I am Rashmi Rajan, one of the registered nurses working in this hospital diabetic clinic. Please be seated. How may I address you and how can I help
you
today?
Sister. My name is John Matthews, and actually I am a diabetic patient, and my diagnosis is confirmed 1 year ago. And now actually why I came here means before 1 month, around 1.5 months, actually I was working in the gardening. I was working something in my garden, the backyard, and something happened. I don't know exactly what was the thing it's happened, but I got one cut on my left foot, and I left over like that because it was nothing like serious, and it was the size of the wound. It was very small. I just wash it out, and nothing. I didn't do anything over there. But gradually, the cut size itself started to increase, and just I did the dressing, simple dressing after washing. I didn't mind because I was somewhat busy in my family. Something was there, some functions was there, so I was a little busy over there. And from 1 week ago, I started to notice that my leg started to pain, and there is swelling, and you can see that my leg, it's already swollen much. So I don't know what is exactly, and my wife told me to go to the clinic and to just to check it out. But I don't know for this cut why I have to come here in the diabetic clinic. Can you just assess me and tell me what is the thing going on here?
Well, Mr. John, I'm so sorry to hear about your cut problem. No need to worry. We are here to help you. Before proceeding further, may I assess your cut if you don't mind? Just I want to get some more clarification regarding your cut, the size, whether it is infected or anything is there. So please, if you don't mind, may I assess it?
You can check it, sister. It's okay.
Okay, John, thank you for allowing me to inspect your cut. So upon my examination, what I can understand that it somewhat started to infect because already you are a diabetic patient, and you told me that this is already 1.5 months over, isn't it? So I'm so sorry to inform you that you are very late to seek the treatment, and because you have already some underlying condition, and this one actually, if you take treatment earlier, this much it will not happen. And I want to inform you that diabetic mellitus, this is a condition where you have to take care much. If there is any, even if there is any small cut, you have to take care, but no need to worry. Anyway, I will assess and I will clean your wound first, and let me inform you a concerned physician so that he can come and check your wound, and according to that he will prescribe you the medication. So is it okay for
sister,
you?
It's fine, no problem. But sister, just I have one doubt. What is the relationship between this diabetic and this infected cut? I could not understand.
John,
exactly.
Really, I can understand what's your concern. This diabetic, whenever the glucose level or the sugar level is increased in your blood, so there is a chance to get the infection is more high, because the microorganism can grow in the place where more sugar is available. So for you, you told already that you are already diagnosed with diabetes for 1 year ago, isn't it? And your body contains more sugar than as normal body. So in this case, if you have even whether it's a small cut, there will be chance for getting infection is very high. So that's why I told you that you need to take much more concern regarding the cut, laceration, some open in on your body. But no need to worry, John. This is actually a diabetic clinic, and expert doctors are available here. Actually, the doctor will prescribe you some medications like antibiotics, so that as early as possible the infection can be we can wash it out. Moreover, we will just instruct for you how to do the dressing. Once I will show you how to do, and later on in your home, you can do it twice daily or thrice daily as per your doctor's prescription. So are you okay with that?
Really? Really, it is the first time I'm hearing all about this diabetic and this curd and infection, everything. So, really, if I know before, I could take precautions. What I can do. So, please, sister, give me some suggestions to avoid the further infection.
John, no need to worry. So, I'm glad to give you some suggestions what you can do it in the home. Actually, there are some specialized shoes are available. You can find it in pharmacy, medical pharmacy. So, these shoes, you can use it as like in regular shoes. But there are some benefits are available because it will prevent the further friction, stress, and it will prevent you to get pressure sore. So it is much essential for you to use this special type shoes whenever you will go outside or even when you will walk in the garden, whatever. So please try to find it out in our medical pharmacy and please try to use it on a regular basis. So
actually, to find out a normal shoe, I'm struggling a lot to find out in the shops. And regarding these special shoes, I'm thinking it will be very difficult for me to find it.
Don't worry, Mr. John. It's available in our medical pharmacy. So you can find out any size. It's starting from the medium, large, extra large, double XL, triple XL. Like that, many sizes are available because it's a medical pharmacy. So no need to worry about the shoes and all. I will inform the medical pharmacist and you can approach them today itself. Are you okay with that?
It's fine, sister. It's okay. I will find it out
today. John, for your further information, I would like to give you some more suggestions, especially to prevent further complications. So, are you willing to listen to me regarding this one?
Oh, sure, sister. We can carry on.
Thank you, Mr. John. So, first of all, I would like to inform you that please inspect your feet daily for any cut or any other laceration, the size of the wound, if it is big or if you look, if you look, it's like infectious with the pus or something like that, please try to come to hospital as early as possible. Moreover, you can just see whether there is any blister or any swelling on your soles or palm, over the nearby the cut area. And the same thing. So if you apply your ointment on correct time, I hope everything will be clear out within time. In addition, please keep your feet clean and dry, especially between the toes area. So when you will clean your feet, please give more importance, for more concentration over your toes area and between the toes area. And it is essential for you to keep the toenail trim and cut a gross toenail to prevent a further friction. The last one, I would like to inform you regarding the socks. Please try to change socks daily so that the moisture thing, it will not be there on your feet area. So I hope if you follow all these advices, there will not be not more things to feel worried. And I hope your infection will be okay within a particular time period. And please keep it in your mind to continue your medication as per doctor's prescription. And meanwhile, if you develop any signs and symptoms of infection, like more swelling and more pain and fever, or something you are feeling like very tired or lethargy or something like that, please do not hesitate to contact with us, or please try to get the medical advices as early as possible. So are you getting my point, Mr. John? Do you have any other concerns regarding your problem?
Well, sister, I understood what you told me and I hope I can continue all these advices. I will try my level best to do everything. And I don't have any other concern. It's okay, fine. If there is anything, I will try to get medical advice as early as possible.
Thank you, Mr. John. And let me reassure that nothing is there to worry, and please try to follow all my advices. Meanwhile, I will show you how to do the dressing once after your doctor's consultation so that you can continue the same way in your home. Is it okay for you? If nothing is left over, please wait here for 5 minutes. I will call your concerned physician so that let him check your food and will prescribe the appropriate medications. Okay, is it okay for you?
It's fine. We can carry
on. Then, Mrs. John, please be seated here. I will come back with you in 5 minutes.
I hope everyone enjoyed our OET role play. Thanks for watching.